Today, all across Canada, there were active groups demonstrating in front of their MP's office to support medical marijuana patients' right to grow their own medicine. Here in Medicine Hat, they were in front of Lavar Payne's office, and they were getting lots of honks. I spoke with a local medical marijuana patient turned activist who is interested in defending his rights.
Today we're here promoting education and awareness.
What does it mean?
Well, it changes, it takes away the right for medical patients to grow their own for themselves or have a designated grower grow for them. It hurts me because I'm being forced into a market where I can produce my medicine for $1 to $2 per gram myself, and now I'm going to be forced into the new program, MMPR, where I will have to pay a minimum of $8 plus shipping. Well, it won't be affordable because it's going to cost me 2 months' wages to afford 1 month of meds. Making a stand for what I believe in. You know, a lot of people can't be here just because of their illnesses or disabilities, and they're afraid of the conservative. Everyone that took the right precautions in the, that entered in the program made sure that, like, all the equipment that they use to grow their stuff is all CSA approved. It's not going to have any cause fires, and like all the equipment out there is pre-tested and everything. So, and like, do you see any mold in any other host that has plants? No, not plants. Don't just normally create mold. They take in oxygen or take in carbon dioxide and give off oxygen. So where does the mold come from? You got to determine. You got to look at all the side effects of pills out there. You know, when you take multiple pills for one illness, what's it really doing? Especially when the side effects are more harmful than anything. When you could easily get the beneficial uses out of a plant and not have no harmful side effects at all.
I'm really not sure what the average person in our community's understanding of medical marijuana is, so I did a little bit of research. Here are some statistics that I found. And I'm going to continue doing research. I guess if you have any questions about this thing, feel free to post them here. Maybe somebody else will know the answer. Thanks very much for watching Community TV. Have a great afternoon. Special thank you to my sponsor, Patty, down at Hemptown Rock, who gave me the information about this story. Hello, community of Medicine Hat. I would like to know what your opinion is on this plant. Tell me what you think in the comments section below. Thanks so much for watching.